After going through type 1 and type 2 region definitions, you could probably guess what a type 3 region is going to be. So a type 3 region is a region in three dimensions. I'll just call it, our region is R sub 3, since we called the type 2 region R sub 2 and the type 1 region R sub 1. I'll call this region R sub 3, R with the subscript 3. It's going to be the set of all points in three dimensions, the set of all x, y's, and z's, such that the xz pairs are a member of a domain. I'll call this domain D sub 3, and let's put a comma here. Y is going to vary between two surfaces that are functions of x and z. So y is going to be greater than or equal to the surface, I'll call it h1 of xz is going to be less than or equal to y. Less than or equal to y, which is going to be less than or equal to, y is going to be bounded from above by the surface h2 of xz. And once again, let's close our set notation. So let's think about whether some of these regions that we already saw were type 1 and type 2, whether they're type 3, and then think about what would not be a type 3 region. So let's go to this sphere. What could be our domain? Well, the domain is a set of xz's, and so it's going to be in the xz plane. So over here, our domain could be this region right over here in the xz plane. So I'll color it in. It could be that region right over there in the xz plane. And then the lower bound on y will be the part that is behind the sphere in this direction right over here. Is the stuff. Actually, this might be a little bit hard to visualize since I'm redrawing on top of it. But and then the upper bound on y is going to be this side right over here. It's going to be this side right over here. It's going to be the upper bound. So all of this is now going to be green. Let me redraw the sphere just to make it clear. So assuming that, let me just draw another coordinate axis. So if you have another coordinate axis, the backside of the sphere in the y direction, so I guess let's think of it this way. So this is the hemisphere mark. This is the halfway point for my sphere. And once again, that's kind of the boundary of our domain. And then the backside, let me do the front side first. The front side, y's upper bound, that'd be h2, would be all of this business right over here. So this would be h2. That I'm coloring in. H2 would be the side that is facing in that direction. And let me see how well I can color it. That didn't do a good thing. So H2 is all of this stuff out on this side of the sphere. And then H1 was the lower bound on Y. So it's going to be that side right over there. I know I could draw it probably a little bit neater, but hopefully you get the point. It would be all of that side. And then Y can vary between those two and essentially fill up the region. We make the exact same argument with the cylinder. The cylinder can be defined the same way. So first of all, the sphere is a type 1, type 2, and type 3 region. It meets all of the constraints. The cylinder, at least the way it was oriented there, actually any cylinder, actually will also be a type 3 region. Exact same argument. So let me draw my axes again. And here, to make the cylinder that we've been making, our domain could be a rectangle in the xz plane. So our domain can be a rectangular region in the xz plane, just like that. And then the lower bound on y could be that side of the cylinder, the side facing in that direction right over there. That is the lower bound. And then the upper bound on y could be the side facing in that direction. The upper bound on y would be this side. This side right over there. So once again, this is also a type 3 region. By the same logic, this one right over here, this hourglass, can be a type 3 region. The front side would be this front side right over here, all of this, including that stuff that I, so it'd be all of that. And then the back side, when you think of it in terms of y, the backside would be that part right over there. And once again, this could also be a type 3 region. The domain the domain, let me draw the domain, would be kind of this cross, the boundary of the domain would be this cross section right over here. So the boundary of our domain could be that cross section right over there. The lower bound on y would be the back half of this hourglass. And the upper bound on y would be the front half, would be the front half, right? Let me do that magenta color, because I've been using that, or actually that green color. So the upper bound on y would be this, or I guess you could say this right half, right over here. So what would not be a type 3 region? Well, if we just rotated this around like that. So let me just draw something that is not a type 3 region, just to show you that this definition does not include everything. So something that would not be a type 3 region for the same argument as we've seen before for type 2 and type 1 regions is an hourglass where it's along the y-axis, or at least it's oriented this way. It actually does not have to be right centered on the y-axis. But an hourglass that looks like this, that looks like this, now all of a sudden, the y can't be just expressed as being between two surfaces that are functions of x and z. You would have to break this up in order to do that. But you could break up this region into two type 3 regions. But the whole thing itself is not a type 3 region. So not type 3.